You thought this series was dead.
It's just that they take forever to upload a new one. So yeah, Terminal Secrets, Episode 2 by Stamotech Studios. Hopefully there's no unexpected problems this time. With Episode 1, the Wii didn't want to cooperate with me. Hopefully that changes here. So Episode 2, 537, which I believe is probably the stable that we're going to be listening in on. Assuming the Wii's going to cooperate. This thing does not like Stabletech Studios. Alright. You're murdering me. Thank you. No, not this, not Stabletech Podcast. Don't pull that shit with me again. And now it crashed. I'll be right back. Yeah, you thought the series was over. It's not. Time to react to Terminal Secrets, Episode 2. I've already had some difficulties trying to get this to work. Hopefully we don't have any more.
Alright, seems to be working. Hopefully the volume's up high enough. Hopefully they fix their audio issues that they had. I remember in the last first episode, they didn't do a lot of that. Alright. Is that Pinkin? I think is what we're going to be listening to next time.
Doing some maintenance on Carl's mainframe hub, and I heard her speaking to Pastel about you being late again. They're on their way down now, and they don't seem too happy, so you might want to. Butterfly? Is that?
The final recording of Pink Pippin, loaded onto my Pitbuck for my listening pleasure.
Oh, no, you can't do that. You can't beat yourself up about this stable. It's just the way things are. You just have to try to keep going. Fox so nasty. Okay, let's just get you up to yub. Come on, up you get, Butterfly.
Spare, you're a maintenance worker. How do you know about Stable 81?
Ah, it's terminal update. The Overmare sent it to every pony in the stable.
Did they give
what?
The main pony
she voice?
Nick, calm down, Butterfly. It's okay. The Overmare's message said it's just standard procedure. And since this hasn't happened in about 60 years, she wanted every pony to be accommodating, you know, with regards to.
Oh, so not only does every pony know that I basically meant a genocide, but they've been ordered to dance around me like I'm made of glass?
Butterfly, you aren't guilty of any genocide. You're just tired from not sleeping. You did what you had to do. You did what you were told. We all know the penalty of breaking the rules around here. Every pony knows you aren't in the wrong.
That's some major bullshit.
Alright.
Really?
Alright, fine. If you don't want ponies to dance around you, then so be it. Butterfly Stitch, get your ass out of bed right now before I kick it out myself. Stop moping about and do your job before the she-witch that calls herself your boss makes your life a living hell.
Huh. You know what, Spare?
Red! Holy Please stay moved, Willis. Lend me your ears, because as usual, I need to give you your daily dose. Sorry. Oh, a choice of words, Here's a song I really like. I don't want to go in that room.
The fire?
I'll just let you get back to work.
Alright, Spare. I'll get back to work.
Oi! Take an easy day in analysis. Request that the counselor give you a few days of sick leave. If you're having trouble, you know, being alone right now. Well, you know where my room is. There's a comfortable couch you can sleep on.
Isn't it loud down in maintenance by the power generator?
I like it. Helps me sleep, keeps me calm.
Maybe that's what I need then. Something to keep me calm.
I hope you find a butterfly. I really do.
Thanks, Spare. Listen to
the
song.
See you around, butterfly.
Alright, so is this stupid mainframe we're gonna start talking about? About more gas?
Please. Just gas.
It's coming from my ass. Okay, that was immature. I thought I'd look back in the shirt.
Dad! Me too. Mom! Dad!
Good morning, Annalise. I trust you are prepared for the day.
I'm here, aren't I?
Yay.
What's today's assignment?
Sable 28 has been highlighted as a stable of interest.
You mind telling me what the experiment of this state?
Why not 537?
Actually, never mind. It could be a surprise.
As before, we must review the earlier logs as highlighted by previous analysts.
All right. 5, 3, 7. Let's begin.
The princess isn't dead. There's a rumor in the stable. One of the guards said he saw when the bombs fell.
That's not from Project Horizons.
Masters of our own fate. That's what some asshole in the bar tried to tell me this morning. Tried preaching it to the whole crowd. Disrespectful little prick!
It's a bar, what do you expect?
We'd gone there to give our respects to the princesses. There we all were, most of the stable packed into one small space, breathing onto each other and pressed all up like sardines. There wasn't enough space for everyone. So the rest who wanted to come were all standing in the hallway, standing on the tips of their toes to get a view of the bar, and the rest of us, we... This guy stands up, interrupts our moment of silence, and tries to preach some zebra shit about us being masters of our own fate. That this was a good thing. Still got some of his blood on my hoof. Fuck that guy!
Oh.
Finally, we've been able to restore order within the stable. It's been a rough few months. Stable Tech warned me about that. They told me that ponies would be scared. They'd be confused. Our security forces have performed admirably in keeping the peace.
I've had a hell of a week. The kind where... 5 months buried underground in a steel box with a few hundred other ponies all out of their minds with worry. The Overmare likes to credit us with keeping the peace, but the real hero is Leafy. She's one of the gardeners that mines the stable's orchard. Don't know how she did it, but she's growing tobacco in secret, and none of the guards want to arrest her for it, because, well, we
sounds
all
like
need
America.
A smoke these days.
Actually,
anyway,
sounds like
my
Jamaica.
I don't know how to describe it. Stressful? Nah, that doesn't even come close. I was guarding the stable door with Feather and Sky. Must have been 2 days ago, and it's late. We're all tired and on our last cigarette, so we're passing it between the three of us, trying to ignore the air as best we can. It ain't cold in there, but it ain't hot either. They regulate the airflow here with some unicorn magic or some shit. Man, I don't even know, but I fucking hate it. You can't feel the air against you down here. It's like you're trapped in this state of purgatory. That's pretty much like everything down here. Anyway, so we're at the door. We're tired and trying to ignore the fact that we're still stuck down there. When we hear this voice on the intercom, it's the Overmare, and she's asking for every pony to come down to the stable door. She says she's got a call from Stable Tech, that the radiation died down. We get to leave. I swear, I've never heard ponies move so fast in my life. It was like they were running from the apocalypse all over again. Like they had balefire at their tails and all. They came swarming and shoving their way down. Goddess, we're just so damn sick of this stable. Sick of the grey and the same food.
Oh, be happy or not.
So we're all crowded around the stable door. No one's got their bags with them. Nah, they want to get to the fresh air first, come back to their stuff later. And I'm standing right there with them. I've never been so excited to feel cold in my life. I didn't care if it was snowing, or if it was summer, or if someone was hidden by it. I just wanted to feel the air again. The Overmare comes down to the stable door and she makes some bullshit speech about standing together. About the unity of some such nonsense to which none of us paid a half lick of attention. We just wanted that door open. After all of this waiting, we just wanted the door to be open, which is why... they're just fucking with us! Damn it, they're just fucking with us!
This log has been dedicated priority one. Every Overmare of Stable 28 must listen to my words. We're stuck in here for the long haul, it appears. When we tried to open the stable door, my password was rejected. Instead, we were greeted with a female voice. It sounded as though it were a machine, which told us that the door would open only for the chosen soul, the one who brings happiness to all by herself. The chosen soul cannot know her identity, or she will be given to arrogance and evil. Our mechanics have searched through the stable's maintenance levels, scoured it for an alternative release mechanism, but there's been no luck. It seems we must play Stable Tech's game, so the priority of every Overmare is to ensure that the stable opens, no matter the cost.
Alright, hold up. So that's dated within the first year after the door sealed, right?
Indeed.
Can you take us to the present day? A log that was made yesterday, maybe?
Do you believe you have enough of an understanding of it?
Yeah, you sealed the stable door and told them to look for a chosen one. Obviously, they haven't found it yet, or you wouldn't have me monitoring the stable. I'm also assuming that the bloke who spread the rumor about the princesses was on the Stable Tech payroll.
That would be an accurate assessment, yes.
So you take away their hope for a few months, grind it to dust, and then give them a new god to worship.
A fascinating experiment indeed.
The scenario of Stable 81 was to breed ponies who were wired to see a situation purely through logic. Here, you've given them the blueprints to create a religion-dominated society. The only escape from the misery of their lives is the chosen one you've made up.
The war between ponies and zebras was heavily escalated when Princess Selena took the crown. In part, this was due to the zebras' fear of the stars, and ponies would do anything for their princesses.
That must have been an interesting stable to pitch to the bosses.
I would not know.
All right, take us to a log from yesterday.
For a stable where no pony feels cold, Stable 28 sure has some cold-hearted ponies. But they don't always mean to be cold. It's just something in the air, I guess. Something about this stable that turns good folks bad. But cold hearts are good for a pony like me. For two reasons. Two reasons I can never forget. The first reason is that the cold hearts will always go to warm themselves up at the bar. If you need to find someone, something you do, often in my line of work, you start at the bar. Private detectives only deal with cold hearts. And that brings me to reason number two. Being surrounded by ponies with cold hearts makes it easier to hide amongst them. In my dreams, my mother, Chosen, rest her soul, loves to remind me, Arya Moon, she says, your heart is the coldest of them all. And she's right. Even in dreams, my mom's always right. I've got a cold, cold heart, and nothing could make me happier than knowing that.
Well, talk about an asshole.
Morning, Vienna. What are you reading?
Oh, first draft of the last Arya Moon book I was writing.
Oh, you never let me read that one.
Yeah, because it's awful, Clover.
Oh, your work is never awful.
Tell that to Stingsburg and... Oh, I'm a mama now.
Oh, all right, those are just terrible.
Like all of my new work.
No, you just need to find something you're passionate about writing.
So,
that's all. You shouldn't have stopped writing Arya Food. She had a few great stories left in her.
Arya drained me too much. She was too personal.
So you're content with not being content?
Ah, that's a writer's life, Clover. Never be satisfied with your work.
That's not what's happening to you right now, and you know it. You're grinding. You've been grinding for years, churning out flop after flop.
Yeah, well, that's what you're here for. You're meant to write the good stuff. My books are normally a hoof reach away from the toilet.
It wasn't always like that.
Yeah, well, it's like that now.
I'm going to the service. You coming?
You ask me that every week. Every week, what do I say?
Yeah, well, it was worth a try.
Why did you come here, Clover?
I was passing through and heard you reading through the walls. Why are you recording yourself reading Arya Moon?
So I can listen to it later. What can I say? I like the sound of my own voice.
You know, you could always write a story about the chosen soul.
That nonsense.
Hey, it ain't nonsense. Revere Kalistag and his chapel have given this stable more hope than any of our books.
There's something to be said for that. But after, what, 150 years, you still haven't found your chosen one yet?
The way I see it, it's not finding the chosen soul that's gonna make us happy. It's the search that breeds hope, that brings light to our hearts.
The only place more likely to bring warmth to a cold heart than a bar is a chapel. And yet so many stray to the bar.
Hey, not a bad line.
Yeah, not a great one either.
Meh, keep working on it, Vienna. Like you always taught me.
I should watch more G2 later.
Keep working on it.
Clearly, that was a waste of our time. I might suggest that...
Find one of Vienna's childhood logs.
Excuse me?
Find one of her early logs.
This will not shed light on the progress of the stable's experiment.
Just humor me.
Very well.
Hey there, Terminal. I'm not sure, Mom!
Yes, dear?
What am I supposed to do?
Just talk about your day, dear.
Okay, my day was kind of weird. Mom told me that at a certain age, we all have to start making audio recordings. She says it's what the Overmare wants everybody to do. This is pretty weird. So, my day...
Was shit.
Well, I woke up.
Go to the next log she made.
Analyst, I do not see the purpose.
Please.
Computers never see
that
the purpose because computers are stupid.
What feels natural to you, sweetie?
It's so dumb.
Come on, let's go get the sewing machine out. Leave the recording on and we'll do what we normally do.
All right then.
There you go, dear. Feel better?
Yeah, this always helps.
You're so talented. Maybe we should send you to cross-stitch for lessons.
Really? That'd be awesome. I love fixing clothes. And cross-stitch makes the prettiest ones.
They are quite nice. Roger, except to the stable picture soon.
I just had the best day! Cross-stitch is really nice, and I learned so much. He says one day I can make...
Don't worry about that small bit you missed. There was something interesting in it. Wow, I was about to hit a button. That would be dumb.
It looked interesting, so he said I could borrow it. It's about a detective who lived before the war on the surface.
Detective Gumshoe.
Adventures of Mare Malone. So cool. I just finished my book, and it was so good. good! Mirror loads.
This is an adult twist.
Pony, and she can always tell when some pony is lying and nothing escapes her. And she has a really big frizzy mane, which sounds super pretty. And she doesn't use a gun because she thinks killing is wrong, so she always tries to bring the bad guys home peacefully. And she has this partner who used to be a master thief and now is a detective, and they work together to save the mayor, and oh, it's just so cool!
Kay Faraday.
Good morning, Bee. Oh, you're awake. Fiona, have you been up all night?
No.
What were you doing all night?
I was reading this book that I got from Cross Stitch. It's a detective book, and it's about this mayor who solves crimes, and...
all right, it's a good thing you've been reading more. It's not the worst thing Philly could be doing. Just don't forget to sleep.
Love, can I sleep in?
You can sleep for an hour.
But Mom...
That's what happens when you read all night, dear.
So, I've been thinking. It's been about a month, and I've been learning from Cross Stitch. I mean, I still love fashion and sewing. It's so much fun, and Cross is great. But, I don't want... That is... you're just a stupid terminal. You can't judge me. I don't want to be a seamstress. I want to write a book, like Mayor Malone. It'll be so cool. I've already written the first chapter. I mean, it kind of sucks and it's silly, but it was so much more fun to do. I need to tell my mom.
The following book takes place 5 years later.
There's no sound better in all the world than the sound of moaning. Get your mind out of the gutter. I'm talking about the song, Moaning. There's no slow down. Instead, it just jumps. For the throat with the sax solo that the goddess herself must have made possible. There's no room for ifs and maybes with that song. It don't compromise, it don't show me any friggin' mercy.
Okay, that should be the last text I get. Whoa, camera. Is the camera standing? Holy shit,
the camera's standing on its own again. Oh,
that's the way it's gotta be. For gals like me. That's the way it's gotta be for guys like you, Cobalt. That's the life we've chosen after all. You killed your wife, and nothing you do is gonna stop me from making you pay. You can try to fight me, but you're gonna lose. You can run, but I'm gonna find you. And I think you know that, don't you? So, I'm gonna finish my drink, and when the glass goes back onto the counter, you're gonna have your hooves right next to it, so I can put my cuffs on them. If they aren't on the counter by the time I finish my drink, this night's gonna turn ugly.
Damn, Vienna! That's some hardcore shit right there! Aria Moon is badass!
You could have waited till we were playing a more upbeat song to read that to us, though.
They don't play upbeat songs in this bar, Pickett.
Take it easy on her, Vienna. She's new.
Right. Sorry. So, you like the piece, then?
Damn right I do. Oh, and right on cue, there's Gentle Station.
Oh, Weevil's got a date with the Revered's daughter.
Shut up, Vienna. Besides, your climax is still a little weak.
Oi! This book's climax is perfect.
Who said I was talking about the book?
You dirty fucker!
See ya.
You and Weevil know each other for a long time, then?
You could say that. I started hanging around him and his mates during school so I could research the stables. Misfits for Aria Moon. It's been a few years, but I'm finally ready to publish this beast.
And you and Evie, you're together?
Hey, clean your ears out. He just said he had a date with Cal Stedge.
But what he just said to you,
No, it's a joke. It can be like that sometimes. Evil and I are just...
Hey, I was listening to that.
Enough of this distraction, Analyst. Please return to the focus of your assignment.
All right, but we're coming back to this later. How many terminal entries were flagged by analysts within a similar time frame as this recording?
You. The closest is 1 year after the log you just listened to.
All right. What's the state of the stable?
Well, the church remained in a state of peace for a long time. However, a sudden wave of accidents caught the eye of another analyst.
accidents.
Indeed. Naturally, they were more than just simple accidents.
All right. Roll the clip.
In the name of the Chosen Soul, I greet you. Good morning, ponies. As always, the sermon will be recorded and broadcast across the stable.
We begin by reading the tale of the revered Ethios.
And it was that the voice of the Omnipresent spoke to us, her words marking the birth of our order, even if we did not yet know it.
It was said that our world in the above, on the surface, was corrupt, led by whores and the godless. Our ancestors raised their royalty to godhood, and now we are being punished for their transgressions. Beware, beware the wrath of the Chosen Soul.
It was revered Ethos, the first leader of our faith, who saw the truth after the voice told us we were to remain in this prison until the Chosen Soul had arrived and the revered began the search for the incarnate God, the Chosen Soul.
We read the words of the revered Ethios. It was thought that before that a pony could never be inhabited by a celestial form. But these are the terms for our release. And so we shall begin in the search. The seekers of the Chosen shall be known as the revered, and they hold authority, overshadowed only by the Overmare. This is how we shall achieve peace.
My daughter Callistine will now lead us in song.
Our stable did in chaos lie, till the wise revered did raise the cry. Peace and order from chaos shall rise at the hands of his servants. The chosen soul shall guide. The chosen soul shall save. We are the chosen. We stand now bond by unity. Our strength poured out for God to see. Peace and order from chaos shall rise at the hands of his servants. The chosen soul shall lead. The chosen soul shall teach. We are the chosen.
Thank you.
Can we get like a summer download but with like an instrumental in the background?
Script 7, Coming of the Dwemer. It was on the 17th hour, the end of my guard shift, when the heretics came. Word had spread of a protest. Word had spread that ponies were going to attack the stable door. We were prepared to suppress them. What we were not prepared for was the device they wielded, which deactivated the lights and the security cameras. Our torches were cut, and they were left standing within the hatred-fueled firelight that lit their torches.
Is your power armor?
Indeed, I believed it was the end of us all as we opened fire upon them, unleashing a tidal wave of metal into their bodies. And yet they continued to come. The violence continued for another 15 seconds until the voice arose. It lifted itself high and clear above the bullets and the screams. It called, "Stop this insanity!" Such was the authority of the voice that our weapons ceased fire as if by their own volition. There was silence as the crowds lay on the floor, hardly moving. Over their bodies strode a pony glowing with an ethereal light. He raised up a drawing of a ram's horn, and he cried out, "The gods have spoken to me! They have sent me this image, an image of strength in humility. The Overmare's power has led to death. It has brought shame and violence to our stable. I demand she cease." We thought the stallion insane. Indeed, he was impressive, but he could not force such change within the stable with mere words. and so we took him into custody, threw him into a prison cell, and were about to leave when we heard him speak again. None shall be dead upon this day. It is my will. When we returned to clean the mess at the stable's entrance, we found not a single corpse. Every pony we had shot suffered horrible wounds, but none were fatal. I believe in the pony, the herald of the gods who has led us to the chosen soul. I believe in the herald who has named himself Dwemmyman.
And now we must discuss an important matter.
This is the largest congregation we have had in many years. I understand that the rise in death by accident has troubled many of you, and the stable guard are investigating the possibility that this may be more than a mere accident. And in times of crisis, it is natural to come to seek the aid of a higher power. After all, is comfort not what we are here for?
All right, I think I've had enough of the sermon. Can you skip ahead slightly?
Calistair was highlighted as a pony of interest. Would you like me to shift focus to her?
All right, fine.
Callie!
Weevil? Stable guard, let you out of lockup?
Just for the service. I'm going back into the cell now.
We broadcast all over the stable. You can hear the sermon from your cell, Weevil. So why are you really here?
That. Well, see, I got hooked for stealing a pit book. But since I was over at your place at the time of the theft, I'm curious as to why they think it was me.
Weevil, you don't exactly have the best reputation in the stable.
They told me you refused to comment one way or the other on my alibi.
I didn't want to get involved.
See, I think someone set me up. I think it was somebody who knows I have dirt on.
I don't think you have the credibility to rat on whichever pony you think you have dirt on. Not anymore, at least.
Calistish, this is...
Oh, God's Vienna.
What? What does she have to do with any of this?
You've been spending time with her.
Yeah, research for her books.
Ha! Have you ever actually read an Ariamon book? Have you even read a book before?
Stay away from Vienna. She has nothing to do with this. Us.
Enjoy prison, Weevil.
So, that's the state of the stable.
A fascinating development indeed. With their gods taken from them, and a prophetic instruction delivered to them by a mysterious voice, they have created their own faith.
Well, I suppose this is less sick than tricking ponies into suicide-inducing migraines.
What was that, Annalise?
Nothing. This is still in the past, right? The Vienna they mentioned there is younger than the one in the first audio log we listened to?
That is correct.
Right. Just keeping my head straight. All right, I'm taking a break, and we'll pick up where we left off.
Very well. Please return within the hour to continue.
5, 3, 7. Are we really listening to this again? I mean, yes, I know it's kind of a very odd question. You guys are lucky I'm not a racist everyone trying to skip this.
Mom. Dad. We need to. Mom. Dad.
Get back to your job.
Oh, what's that smell? Oh.
What's that? Who's that?
Just me, Spare.
A mighty analyst paying a visit down to maintenance.
What is the world coming to? Very funny. Where are you?
Under the compression tank.
I have no idea which one that is.
Just follow the sound of my voice.
Hard to hear your voice over this racket.
This racket is what's keeping the stable's plumbing working.
That's gross.
Yeah, well, I never said my job was glamorous. There we go. That's better.
I thought you worked on maintaining the mainframe. Why are you working here?
Guts in the machine equals guts in the machine, Butterfly. They're different machines, aye? But they speak to me all the same. So, what's up?
Just taking a break. I wanted to get out of the analysis chamber for a little.
I never understood why you analysts need entire chambers to work in.
No idea. I always assumed it had something to do with the technology that runs the Crusader mainframe.
Nah. Most of that tech is in the maintenance area. Did you know that the mainframe in this stable isn't on Stable Tech's official records?
Really?
Yeah. They keep it off record as a security measure. Just something interesting I learned a few years back.
I wonder how much of the stable's activities are off record.
Well, I doubt Stable Tech wanted to leave a paper trail announcing we rigged your stables with experiments and we constantly monitor them. It's not great for PR.
Spare, do you think that what we're doing is right?
I think we're doing what we need to. This is our life, Butterfly. It's either do what we're told or...
Or get thrown out into the wasteland. Yeah, I know.
It's going
to... Throw your ass into the wasteland, then. Yeah, we all know what's going to happen.
I don't understand why everybody thinks I can move past this. This wasn't my parents dying or a bad breakup. This was me pressing a button and gassing an entire stable.
To be honest, I don't think they expect you to move past this, Butterfly. I think they expect you to just do your job until one day you can't do it anymore. And on that day, they'll replace you with the next pony.
That's horrible.
And yet, it's still better than being outside in the wasteland.
Is it now?
You've heard the stories, Butterfly.
I should get back to work.
Oi! You taking it easy like I suggested?
Yeah, I found this one pony, Vienna. She's about as far removed from her stable's experiment as she could be. It's helping me keep my mind off everything that's been happening.
Good idea. I'll speak with you later, Butterfly.
See you, Spare. 5, 3, 7.
No, don't listen to it again, please.
Welcome back, Alice.
Spin up logs made by Stable Security within the time frame of the last audio log we listened to, with preference to any that were flagged by previous analysts, from low to high priority.
Very professional. Why focus on the security guards?
They're usually involved or have information on major changes in a stable.
Beginning playback.
We picked up Weevil again today for trying to pickpocket the old man. Typical. That kid's a troublemaker.
Some asshole tried, came in and tried to convince us that Calistej attacked him. As if. But we followed up on it and it came up empty.
Had to break up a bar fight on this last shift. Some of these ponies just can't hold their ground.
We got a tip that the troublemakers who graffitied the church were all gonna try it again at the Overmayor's office. We'll catch him in the act.
Check stun batons.
Affirmative.
Right. Does everyone have their pit bucks recording?
Recording.
Got it.
Alright. They're inside the office. We move in 3, 2...
Get on the ground right now!
I said stick down!
Hey man, get on the ground right now!
Vienna? Oh shit.
Welcome to processing. Please stand in front of the line.
Hey, Flower. Good to see you again. How's your mom?
She's doing great, Weevil. Please stop sending her cigars. They're bad for her health.
She'd find a way to sneak them in without my help. I'm just making it easier for her.
Just get in the damn cell. Vienna, can I speak to you? Vienna, what the hell are you doing with these guys?
Relax. It's just research for the next Aria Moon book.
Research for your... Vienna, you just got arrested!
Yeah, and now I've learned 2 important things.
Like what?
What it's like to be arrested. And that bribing a guard's mom with cigars gets her to take it easy on me.
Do we have any logs from Weevil that have been flagged?
A low priority log has been flagged.
Alright, I think that's got it.
Why are you recording this?
I like listening to myself speak.
Your voice isn't that impressive.
This is the voice that rules this stable's underworld.
Underworld? One group of misfits does not constitute an underworld.
It does in your book.
Yeah, well, I'm blowing things out of proportion in the book.
For the sake of drama.
Mind if I take a peek?
Oh, Weevil. A lady doesn't show off her goods till she's good and ready.
Yeah, well, I got a couple of ladies who are always good and ready.
You are just so very charming. Did you know that?
I have been told.
So, what are you gonna do about Calistej?
Vienna?
Oh, come on, Weevil. I know she's the one who framed us for the graffiti in the church. I wasn't there, so it definitely wasn't me. And you're way too involved with the church, so I know it wasn't you.
You know, my mom used to think I was the chosen soul. She was adamant that it was me, says the voice at the door spoke to her. She used to take me to that stable door for hours on end, and just... Of course, in the end, it wasn't me. But what I got out of it was a family. All the ponies in that congregation, they're my family. Taught me that we don't hurt people. I learned that from them. Calistage, she never learned that. She's dangerous, and she's not a character in your book, either. So you back down, Vienna. You back down, and let me handle this.
She's violent, Weevil. She's unstable. You should tell the stable guard.
Just
tell them what?
The stable,
that the priest's own daughter's on a fast track to becoming a murderer? They'll never believe me, Vienna. Now, I've got to sell this my way.
What happened next with Weevil? Did he make any more logs?
Negative. However, we have flagged in recording from our hidden listening devices.
All right, let's hear it.
Oh, dear, that was a terrible for your health.
Well, look who's suddenly so concerned about my health.
You're being absurd, Weevil. I always cared for your health. And for you.
Then stop what you're doing, Kelly. You've hurt ponies.
I haven't killed a soul, Weevil. In the court of public opinion, in the history books, Calistage hasn't killed a single pony. Meanwhile, Weevil's friends, well, they've been very naughty.
Don't you dare, Kelly.
And if you continue to fight me, I think history might remember Vienna as the worst of the lot.
You're going to
get back down, and we might be able to salvage the relationship you so callously shattered. Understand?
If I say yes.
Then any future accidents that happen in the stable will have nothing to do with you or your friends, Weevil.
But those accidents, they're still going to be happening.
Oh, well, you wouldn't deprive a lady of her favorite pastime. Some ponies find meaning in worship. Some ponies drink and fight and fuck. And me? I guess I like to watch ponies dance. I like to play with them.
You like to play, but you haven't told any pony what the rules are.
I'm waiting for some pony smart enough to figure those rules out, Weevil.
Calistash, I'm sorry, but I'm not playing this game anymore.
Weevil? Weevil, put the gun down!
You're not going to keep hurting ponies, Calistash. You're out of control.
Weevil, you can't. We're meant to make a life together, Weevil. I love you, Weevil. Please. Please don't hurt me.
Don't shoot the bitch.
I'm sorry. I couldn't keep up the scared man act anymore. Say, you don't mind if I take a quick smoke, do you?
What are you?
I'm sorry. That wasn't my best attempt at being the victim. That's the usual nonsense I hear before I, you know. Don't hide me. Look at me. I wet myself. Seriously, though, hon. You really thought I came out here by myself? That guy behind you, for example.
What?
Surprise! There wasn't any pony behind you at all. And I just got you to turn your back on me.
Oh, shit.
I'm glad it happened this way, Weevil. The view of you is just so much better from behind.
This session must be recorded for future revision. Do you understand?
Yeah. Yeah, I understand.
Now then, Weevil was your friend?
He was.
The loss of a good friend is a terrible thing. I am so sorry for your loss. We must move you to a state where you can accept this. As such, I would like to begin by asking you to tell me that your friend, Weevil, is dead.
Excuse me?
You need to say the words. Say them to me. It makes what happened true. It makes it real.
My friend. My friend Weevil is dead.
Is there an audio log on the record from Vienna? I'd say she just became a figure of interest in this stable.
So, this is what Vienna calls a home.
It's
not too shabby, I suppose.
What the hell are you doing here?
Please, Vienna, Pony's asleep. Lower your voice. Get out of my room.
Oh, you are quite the late arrival. What were you doing so late? Misbehaving?
No. I was seeing a therapist, since my best friend was quite brutally murdered.
Ah, yes, by an unknown individual.
I think we both know who that individual was, Calistege.
Oh, I'm certain we both know not only who killed Weevil, but also that you are well out of your league. We don't exist in one of your books, Miss Vienna. You are not Arya Moon. I also think we both know that if you decide to pursue a course of action against the individual who took Weevil from this world, you'll face a much worse fate. I think we both know that this is your chance to disappear, to become a nameless face in this stable, and to fade into obscurity. If you need time to decide, I left your terminal's recording device online. Feel free to listen to this conversation as many times as you'd like. But don't think about showing it to the stable guard. I'll find out.
Vienna is referenced in this next flag log from several years before the present day and 2 years after the log we just listened to.
Hi, Pipbuck. We've come a long way from recording this on my mom's terminal. I wonder what she'd think of me now. She'd probably call me a coward. I can't beat Calistish. I'm scared. I'm scared of what she... What the?
What's going on here?
It's the Revere Tybalt. He's been murdered.
All right. I have a counseling session coming up in a few minutes. I have time for one more log. We've done enough last logs. Bring up the current security feed on Vienna if she's in range.
Understood.
I like how the terminal suddenly obeys.
Been a part of its inner workings, grinding against the other cogs in the endless circle that we spin. And yeah, I got rested up. I spent time away in the dark shadows, keeping quiet and staying closed up. I kept myself to myself, for the good of no pony but myself. That won't apply anymore. Hell, it can't. There was once a time where I'd end my day milling in the stables bar, waiting for some ratbag or lowlife to waltz his way in like he owned the place. And then it'd always be the same after that. I'd corner him and talk him down with a story just like this one. I'd convince him to turn himself in, and then I'd be gone. Vanishing into a puff of cigarette smoke with a wisecrack and an attitude. Those were the days. Those were my days. But the thing what happened to me is the same what happens to all bad folks that pretend to be good. We get caught by someone badder and smarter who's even better at hiding their true self. See, it's the hiding that makes for a good detective. Not a good villain. Or a good anything, really. What I never realized before was that I was being a coward the entire time. My life was under threat, it's true. And even if I sunk my enemy, she would get back. I'd be regardless, and I know her retaliation would be fatal. My mistake all this time was regarding my life as worth saving. Not anymore. because Arya Moon declares war, at least on the mayor who wronged her. This is about to end.
Well, that's a hell of a piece, Vienna.
You think?
It needs tweaking here and there, but hell, I'm just so happy that Arya Moon's coming back!
Oh, she's coming back, but not in my house.
Excuse me?
I want you to finish the next book. Take my notes. Take my draft.
Me? Write for Arya Moon?
You've earned this, Clover. She's all yours. You love Arya Moon.
Let the lucky
more than I do. And you'll do her justice.
No. I doubt that's even.
I don't know what to say, Vieta.
Whatever it is you decide to say, make sure you say it as a monologue. Arya Moon doesn't speak in one-liners, after all.
Well, to Arya Moon!
To Arya Moon.
All right, keep track on Vienna for now. I'm going to my therapy session.
I will alert you if there are any serious changes in the stable.
Blah, blah, 6, 7, or 3, 5, 7. I forget what they were.
What? Guess I'm hearing things.
Again?
Miss Stitch. Please, sit down. Now, you are aware that these sessions are recorded?
Yeah, I'm pretty aware.
I'm sure you've heard many counseling sessions in your time as an analyst.
So much for confidentiality.
Miss Stitch, may I call you Butterfly?
You could.
All right, then.
But I think Miss Stitch works better for me.
Oh, well, all right, then. Miss Stitch, let's start simply. How has your day been?
Well, I haven't killed any pony today, so that makes it better than yesterday.
I'm a patient much like you a long time ago, when I first took up my position here, in fact. I'm sure you're aware that you aren't the first pony who has had to terminate a failed stable.
Yeah, supposedly only one other stable has actually needed to be purged.
Well, that's not entirely correct. Other stables have reached the same failures as Stable 81. However, there were malfunctions in the systems, it seems, and the purge attempts failed.
Why couldn't I get one of the duds?
It took several years before the other analyst was able to recover. I must be honest, this is going to be a long process. However, I enjoyed significant success with the other patient.
Enjoyed?
What I mean is, the success was important. I did not enjoy his suffering or the events that led to his mental state, but it was heartening to learn that he could be helped.
And you think you could help me?
I do. When you come for your next session, that analyst will be present, talking through your experiences and your guilt with some pony who understands you is important. I understand from a report your supervisor gave in, you copied a file from Stable 81 onto your pipbook?
I did.
Could you tell me what it is that you...
Why don't I just play it for you?
I don't think that's strictly necessary.
Too bad. We're gonna... This is a lot of questions, so we have to listen to the same thing over and over again.
What do you think of that?
No, that's awful. Miss Stitch, I must ask that you delete that file from your pipbook. This is not a healthy obsession for you to have right now.
I think I passed healthy the moment I pressed that button.
Lamenting yourself is not going to help you. Delete the file immediately.
Fine.
Let me take a look at your pipbook. Good. It's been deleted.
Can I go now?
You may, but you must return tomorrow.
Oh, sorry. am I interrupting?
Ah, I have another patient now anyway. Miss Stitch, this is...
Blueball. The guy who gave me Stable 81. Yeah, I know the voice.
Oh, I am so sorry about that. I should...
Shut up.
Welcome back, analyst. How was your session?
Perfect. It went perfectly. I'm cured of insanity now.
You were never insane.
Where's Vienna now?
She's having her lunch. But you missed a meeting she had with Kalisteg in her office earlier. Shall I play that back?
Yes, why do you even need to ask me this?
Beginning playback.
Thought I had explained this very clearly to you.
Oh, now there's no need for you to get upset, revered Kalisteg. I'm just here for a drink. And a talk.
I'm calling Stable Security.
All right. I'll pour a drink for them as well. Say, you don't mind if I smoke as well? That's really good. You want one?
What do you want, Vienna? Like I said, just want to talk. Why should I believe you aren't here to kill me?
Well, you would have called Stable Security by now if you actually thought I was a threat. See, I figured something out recently. I figured out you're just a talker. That you've been bluffing your whole life. And we've been falling for it.
If that's true, then you're admitting to falling for it harder than anyone else.
Oh, I'm not denying that, sweetheart. There'd be no point.
Nah, you've beaten me before, and it scared me so bad I sat in a hole for most of my adult life doing nothing as a result. And now?
Oh, I'm just here to let you know that I'm writing again. Just here to ask for you to maybe promote my new book. Your father loved the last one, and we all know how much you loved your father.
Get out of here! I have a ceremony to plan for.
Just a friendly house call is all. I'll be seeing you, Kalisteg.
And so the endgame is coming, it seems. Take us to the live feed.
Hey, you can't smoke in here.
Hi.
Let me. How dare you? I'm going to inform the guard.
Yeah, you do that. Well, you look like you're having a terrible day.
You're such a flatterer, Clover.
Yeah, you're right. I've had better.
So, how was the service?
Revered Kalisteg thinks the church found the chosen soul.
Wow, third one this week.
Seems that the more ponies go missing, or meet with an accident, equals more ponies being her chosen soul. Ponies are scared. There's still a killer on the loose.
The killer has been on the loose for years. And so far, any pony who's followed the curfew laws and stayed in line hasn't been harmed.
I can't help but hate how we've just come to accept that there's a murderer running around the stable. Trust me, we won't win this killer's game. We can't play it if we don't know the rules.
Switching topics, you said there's a new chosen soul. So why aren't you more excited about it?
It's just posturing. Kalisteg has tried to raise our spirits.
Except she knows our hopes will be dashed every time she raises them. But she ignores that part.
What was that?
Nothing, Clover.
Nothing.
When are they gonna try to open the door?
They're on their way right now. I thought I'd grab a quick bite to eat before I headed off there.
Well, you go on ahead. I'll catch up.
Alright. See you at the door.
Oh, I'm certain we both know not only who killed Weevil, but also that you are well out of your league. You don't exist in one of your books, Miss Deanna. You are not Arya Moon. I also think we both know that if you decide to pursue a course of action against the individual who took Weevil from this world, you'll face a much worse fate. I think we both know that this is your chance to disappear, to become a nameless face in the stable, and to fade into obscurity. If you need time to decide, I left your terminal's recording device online. Feel free to listen to this conversation as many times as you like. But don't think about showing it to the stable guard. I'll find out.
I'm sorry, Mabel. I can't stay out of it anymore.
And now the time has come. We have paid our dues to the gods, and they have heard us.
chosen soul, open the door and free us!
This is not the chosen soul. The stable door will remain sealed. Have a nice day.
Take heart, my little ponies. Our freedom is merely a delay. Calistash? Calistash! Excuse me? Who addresses me? I do. You remember who I am, right? I'm afraid I do not. Perhaps it's best that we stay that way? No, it isn't. Ponies, every pony, listen. My name is Vienna, and Calistash is a liar. Security, detain her. Detain her immediately. She murdered Weevil, and she murdered her own father. She is responsible for all of the... Hey, get your hooves off me. I apologize, my flock.
You're not going to keep her ponies, Calistash. You're out of control.
Weevil, you can't. We're meant to make a life together, Weevil. I love you, Weevil. Please. Please don't hurt me.
Busted. Which means two characters are
covered. I couldn't keep up this stupid mad act anymore.
I saw Weevil before he went to find you. I set his pitbox recording function on, just
the usual nonsense I hear before I, you know.
I was so scared, so terrified of what you'd do to me if I made this public. And even if I brought you down, they'd still kill me.
That guy behind you, for example.
What?
Surprise! There wasn't any pony behind you at all.
I just got you to turn your back on me.
Well, I don't care anymore.
I'm glad to have it this way, Weevil. The view of you is just so much better from behind.
It's over, Calistash. I don't care if you arrange my death after we throw you in a cell. I'm tired of living in your shadow. Stay back. Stay back, all of you. She's got a gun. Everybody, get down.
You'll never catch me, Vienna.
Give me your gun.
Huh?
Shit. She's going into the maintenance area. Where are you? Come on out, Calistash. It's over.
No, it's never over. Never!
You'll never recover from this. There's nothing you can do.
That's not true, Vienna. I could still kill you.
That sounded like an oi, didn't it? Ha! This is real life, Vienna. This isn't one of your books. Don't you realize that by now? In real life, you fail. In real life, your heroes don't win. Because in real life, there's no such thing as a hero or a villain. Just the winner and the loser. And now, you're going to die. And then I'll spin my web, pick up where I left off, and you will be forgotten about. This is how it ends, Vienna. With me leaving the stable into the future, and you, a writer of awful books, dying in the dark. Now, to fuck you. My books are awesome.
She's gone down into the lower levels.
I need to find her.
What happens to the stable now?
I expect that nothing will happen to this stable. The experiment will continue until an analyst delivers a verdict. Something you do not have the information to do.
I wish I could help Vienna somehow.
Do not think of these subjects as ponies. They are our experiment, and their reason for existing is to help the future of ponykind. I understand from your tone today and from your actions that you are hurt by your choices yesterday. I may have some insight that could help you understand the importance. Please, analyst. Tell me one good thing that would have come from these stables we have analyzed in the past 2 days.
Well, I guess. A world where ponies thought only with logic, where they thought every variable through before acting, would be a far safer one. Rebuilding the world would be faster, more efficient. This stable, it's brought ponies a new belief system. It's taught them that they can find a way to stand united, even if their leadership is flawed. Verity and logic, important things to have. I suppose if there's one good thing to take away from all of this, is those were noble intentions.
Return your attention to the stable, analyst. Vienna and Calistag are on the lowest levels of the stable now.
I know you're in here, Calistej! I'm playing your game! I know the rules now! You don't know the rules, Vienna! You stumbled onto my game, head first, without a thought in your mind, and without preparation, you rushed without thinking it through, and now look where you are! I'm gonna kill you, Vienna! Then I'm going to kill every pony else in the stable! I've watched you all dance for so very long, so many years, it will be the game's grand finale! You have been weighed! You have been measured! And you have been! You're going to try to kill me! You don't! I repeat, you do not quote my own fucking books to me! I've got a gun, Vienna. I have clear line of sight, and I call the shots. You don't tell me what to do. I'm in control. I'm in power. You are nothing. You are scum. You are
holding a grenade in my pocket.
What?
Yeah. I nicked it from one of the guards. Ta-da. Grenade blew a hole in the floor. There's another room down there. Let's take a look and see.
Oh dear. What?
It appears Vienna has found our hidden door controls.
Oh my.
It looks like it used to be a terminal system. Well, whatever it was for, it's destroyed now.
All stable residents, please hear me. The stable door has opened! The stable door has opened!
What?
Well, damn. I didn't see that coming.
I guess your chosen soul actually did exist.
That is unlikely. This is a complete coincidence. This is...
a complete success. The stable door is opened, and I'm closing the file on this sale.
I understand. Is there anything more you wish of me, Analyst?
Yeah, I was reading some documents on Stable 81, and I wanted to make sure I had the correct information.
Of course, Analyst.
What was the death toll for the stable?
537.
Oh,
why?
Look
at that. Analyst? Butterfly?
Oh, jeez, what? It's a black screen now. Oh wait, is that it? Really? Am I fast?
Here I stand, my heart at your command.
Well,
what will the verdict be?
I'm sorry
while
I don't say much,
your
but
answer.
This is an actually a very interesting series. I think the Crusader Maker was a bitch, and I'll probably say that at some point in every episode reaction I do, but...
I'll never make the same mistake.
I actually do like this song. Sorry. Butterfly, I keep forgetting
the name.
But yeah. Definitely.
Your love too tightly.
Beyond the Siege, okay, I'll leave that
from the song.
That's at the end of it. Is that the ow? The end? This is why I don't like my leg. So yeah, subscribe to StableTech Studios who make that awesome shit, and with that, I'm gone. I'm bad at outros.